begin with 3/4 inch brush. Gonna mix up some grey mix, ultramarine blue, burnt sienna, touch of raw sienna. Same three. That'll do it. Let's go. Starting in using a whole arm. No wrist action here. As we come down, we need to get a bit stronger. So that's the first wash. Not going to mess too much with that. Bring in some water. Leave a little like that. More water. Bring in some mix. A bit warmer. That's it, job done. Leave it. That's stage one. Here we go then. Recording stage two. I'm going to mix up some more grey. Same three hues. The usual. Straight in here. Careful painting. Gravity do work. I said that, not gravity work. Coming down. Taking the same mix, I might just warm this up slightly here. Maybe touch. Get a bit of warmth to come down. Some little chunks of light in there. Keep coming down. same mix, just slightly touching in here. It's a synthetic brush, well, Royal Langnickel. Still coming down. That's done with this tower. I need to get that correct. Get all dirty. Again, we've got the dome. There's a slightly different mix in here because let's just keep that nice and loose. Let that do its own thing in there. There we go. Fine if it's dry. Just fiddling with some of these tiny pieces. It's going to do it. Leave that. It's looking pretty good. I might just touch in some blue in here. Just a little touch. And these turrets. Just let that bleed down a bit. Something. Kind of echo it in places. Just to define some of these shapes really. Just feather touch. Let it do its own thing. It really is important to just sick all that paint. So I want that to go back further, which it's doing now. This to come forward now, which it's done slightly because it's a slighter tone darker. These are not exact as they are, but it's quite a nice effect there. I'm quite happy with that at the moment. And that's it. That's stage two, done. So here we go. Stage three. I'm going to touch in a little bit of Payne's grey into this mix. Just making sure that this is still wet in places, which it is, and I'm just going to let it do its own thing on this roof. I want this to be kind of like the focal point area here. So again, just encouraging it to run, to do its own thing really. I don't need to be too precise about it. I'm going to bring this forward. In reality, this is slightly forward. So, this is just tickling in the paint. So I'm doing this before I actually touch the paint. This is important to kind of get a feel for what I'm going to do. And that's pushing these back here. So these are now going back further. This is coming forward. You can see that. I just want to differentiate between this cathedral and this area here. Touch it. Same watery mix, paint's great. Gonna come in here, establish this line. Just doing that, basically. So these statues are on this wall. Keep it simple. Tonally, I'm gonna come a little bit darker. Too much water to this. I'm adding some sepia there. Keep this nice and liquid. Similar kind of mix in here. Kind of like that. Might warm it up a little bit. Just cool it down. But I'm going to warm up in a second. There we go. Lovely quality, just let it do something. That's cool. On the wall. I definitely need to warm that up in here. To bring that forward, so I'm going to bring in some water still damp. Almost neat. Let it blend and bleed. I'll do something. Let's warm that up. Now. So that's that stage done. Next stage is I'm going to bring in some of these statues. There'll be a lot of paint grey in this. Just put some water in there. It's still quite damp, so that's just going to blur. It's just like, watch, there we go, which I kind of don't mind, in parts, because I want this to blend and bleed down here a bit. I thing is here, important, not to fiddle too much. I've just got these figures up on this pedestal. Just remember their silhouettes. Okay, let's come over to this one. Next one. Just touching in. That's it. Next one. Tiny little head. That. Done. Just let it blend and bleed. There was a little one there, it's too damp. This is quite damp. But let's take a risk. Let's come in. It's quite nice to get it to blur, and then we've got mist back here. It's just a suggestion.
Okay.
In this next stage, I'm going to strengthen up the shadows. Ultramarine and Alizarin Crimson. Just going to warm them up a little bit there. These are going to be quite strong. This is still damp in here. I know we've got a lot of shadows coming in here, but I'm just going to bring in shadow. I'm not sure it's a tree or quite what it is there, but I just need strengthening up down here to push things back. It's quite nice if things sort of blend and bleed and you've got some sharp and lots of sharp stuff in there. So pop in a touch of burnt sienna. Just light touches in here. I'm going to do a bit of feathering in there, some just clear water. Just in here. Just let them run through a touch. It's good to make sure that shadows don't all look the same tone. Otherwise they look pretty dire. That's running, it's not great. Too much in there really. I'm going to take that right off the page. And we'll just bring in a touch here. And we'll have, say, some strong shadows in there. It's kind of nice. Just touching in. Not too much. Think we're almost done. We're almost done in here now. There you go. If you're gonna go with shadows, we could bring in some slightly darker ones in on here, but it's kind of being a bit panicky here. Feathering those. Thing is, might strengthen up this one to push back some of the others on there. And I'll just touch in some darker tones in here. This wall onto a dry brush just to mix it up a little bit. Just about done. We can have a little spray up, see what happens. Not much. It'll do a stain, and that's about it. Job done. Final job. Little job, small four brush, taking that same shadow colour, ultramarine, a touch of Payne's grey in there just to cool it down a bit, and just here, just kind of intimate. Shadow just there, lovely. And I'm not happy about this lamp. It's a bit of work, but the lamp is too fat. Because the light's coming in from the left. I need to kind of establish some of these shadows to the right. Yeah, that's working. I'm too worried down here, it's just getting panicky a bit if you're not careful. That's fine, that looks good. Just touching a little bit here. Shapes. Okay, I'm gonna actually take out just re-wet this. And then take it out on the tissue. Return. Some tissue. See the run there. Make sure you turn the tissue, otherwise you end up getting the wrong blobs in. It's kind of about right. Keep it turned. Quite nice for just softening a few edges. Straight out the tube, white paint, touch in here, not much. This bothers me. Fine. Just going to bring in these. Not much. Go away. Go away. Okay. No. No. Little brush there, it's zero. I'll put them down. Some Payne's grey, ultramarine. Twigs and stuff, they come in at all kinds of angles. You can be here all day doing this. It's next brush, here we go. Yeah, hammer that up a bit. Yeah, so I've hammered that up straight into neat paint. I'm going to spray that a bit. This is the green, straight into it. I need to take a bit of Payne's grey in there as well. And this is kind of like this motion. Yeah. I'm just dabbing it in different kinds of. That's it, really. That's it. Stop that. Last little bit. Back to this brush. smaller brush. Just to give some more energy in there, right? More contrast. That's a bit more drama, a bit more impact. And that's it, done. One more little thing, just a little brush on the end. So that's it. Pretty dramatic. Prague. There you go.